Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Agarwal, Assistant Professor in IPM Group of Institution, Ghaziabad, UP. Today we are here to discuss some basic concepts of working capital management. So let's start our today's topic. First of all, let's understand the meaning of working capital. Working capital means the firm's holding of current or short-term assets of a business, like cash, receivables, inventory, marketable securities, or bank balance. These items are also referred to as circulating capital. Corporate executives devote a considerable amount of attention to the working capital management. Now, here a question arises in our mind, what is working capital management? So, working capital management is concerned with the problem that arises in attempting to manage the current assets, the current liabilities, and the interrelations that exist between them. Current assets are those assets which we want to convert in cash within 1 year. Similarly, current liabilities are those liabilities which we have to pay off within 1 year of time period. So, in working capital management, we will see what is the effect of current assets and current liability in our business in terms of liquidity and what is the interrelationship between these two terms. So, this is about working capital management. Concept of working capital. There are two possible interpretations of working capital concept. With the help of balance sheet, we can also measure working capital, as well as with the help of operating cycle concept, we can measure working capital of a business. So now, let's understand these two concepts. Let's try to understand balance sheet concept of working capital. There are two interpretations of working capital under the balance sheet concept. First is excess of current assets over current liability, or in other words, we can say net current assets. So, second one is gross or total current assets. In other words, we can also say that through balance sheet, we can calculate current assets in two manner, that is gross working capital and net working capital. Gross working capital is total of current assets, whereas net working capital is excess of company's current assets over their current liabilities. So, this is the balance sheet concept of working capital. Now, let's see the types of current assets. Working capital is broadly divided into two types, that are on the basis of concepts and on the basis of time. On the basis of concepts, current assets are further divided into two types, that are gross working capital and net working capital, that we just discussed. Or if we want to revise, so gross working capital is current assets or total current assets of a company, and net working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. Whereas on the basis of time, current assets or working capital are divided into two parts, that are permanent or fixed working capital and temporary or variable working capital. So, gross working capital refers to firm's total investment in current assets. Gross working capital focuses on financing of current assets. So, it's basically looking after the current assets of business. Whereas, net working capital refers to the difference between current assets minus current liabilities. Net working capital focuses on liquidity position of the firm. Means, क्या कंपनी के पास इतनी करंट एसेट्स हैं कि वो अपनी करंट लायबिलिटीज को उन्हीं करंट एसेट्स में से भुगतान कर सके? अगर है, so it's mean that that company is having sound liquidity or they are in good position. So, net working capital focuses on liquidity position of the firm. Then next is permanent or fixed working capital. It is a minimum level of current assets which is continuously required by a firm to carry on its business operations. It's referred to as permanent or fixed working capital, whereas fluctuating or variable working capital is the extra working capital needed to support the changing production and sales activities of the firm. It is referred to as fluctuating or variable working capital. We can also present permanent and temporary working capital with the help of graph. Here, we have taken time on x-axis, whereas on y-axis, we have taken amount of working capital. This parallel line to x-axis shows permanent working capital, whereas this line or this curve, fluctuating line, is showing temporary or fluctuating working capital. Whatever will be the time period, temporary working capital will be changed or can be changed. But if we talked about permanent working capital, it will not fluctuate because of time period. It is permanent. Now, the second concept of working capital is operating cycle. Now, what is operating cycle? Let's see. Operating cycle is the time duration required to convert sales after the conversion of resources into inventories into cash. The operating cycle of a manufacturing company involves three phases. First is acquisition of resources such as raw material, labor, power and fuel, etc. Second, manufacture of the product, which include conversion of raw material into work in progress into finished goods. Third, sale of the product either for cash or on credit. Credit sales create account receivables for collection. So, operating cycle means the time period which is required by a company to convert their sales into cash. अब अगर हम एग्जांपल की बात करें, सो टू कंपनीज अगर हम यहां लेते हैं, एक कंपनी जिसका ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल कम है, मींस दे कैन इजीली और दे कैन कन्वर्ट देयर सेल्स इनटू कैश इन मिनिमम टाइम ऑफ पीरियड, वेयर एज अनदर कंपनी इज हियर जो कि अपने कैश में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए सेल्स को ज्यादा टाइम पीरियड लेगी. सो वर्किंग कैपिटल रिक्वायरमेंट कौन सी कंपनी की ज्यादा होगी? ऑब्वियसली जो हमारी सेकेंड कंपनी है, विच विल रिक्वायर मोर टाइम टू कन्वर्ट देयर सेल्स इनटू कैश. सो दैट इज द ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल, दैट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग साइकिल ऑन द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ वर्किंग कैपिटल. नाउ लेट सी सम एडवांटेजेस ऑफ एडिक्वेट वर्किंग कैपिटल. फर्स्ट इज सॉल्वेंसी ऑफ अ बिजनेस. सेकेंड, गुडविल. नाउ सी, if company is having good working capital management or having adequate working capital, they can manage their expenses, they can manage their assets, so it will raise their goodwill, so it will affect their business also. Then third is easy loan. Now a company, if a company can pay off their current liabilities from their current assets, so they can easily gain the loan because they are having good liquidity position, having good financial position. So it is easy to them to gain the loan. Next is cash discounts. Because they are having goodwill in a business, so they can easily get discounts also. Now, next is regular supply of raw material. Because they don't have idle money or idle funds in a business, they are regulating their money, they are investing their money, and they are having enough liquidity in a business, so regular supply of raw material will be there. Unka business kabhi bhi raw material ki wajah se band nahi hoga because they don't have funds. The next is regular payment of salaries, wages and other day-to-day expenses. Same, because they are having good liquidity in a business, they are managing their cash, their funds or their current assets properly, so they can easily pay their expenses as well. The next is ability to face crisis. Because they are handling their cash, their assets properly, so they can face crisis as well. अगर किसी टाइम पीरियड में कंपनी को लगता है दे आर नॉट हैविंग सफिशियंट मनी और सफिशियंट लिक्विडिटी, सो वो अपनी करंट लायबिलिटीज या अपने एक्सपेंसेस कम कर सकती है और वो ट्राई कर सकते हैं कि कैसे अपने बिल्स को कैश करवाया जाए, कैसे अपने डेटर्स से कैश लिया जाए, सो दे कैन फेस क्राइसिस एज वेल. सो दीज आर सम एडवांटेजेस टू हैव एडिक्वेट वर्किंग कैपिटल. नाउ लेट्स सी सम डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ एक्सेसिव वर्किंग कैपिटल. सो फर्स्ट इज आइडल फंड्स. Because company is having more funds, so they are not investing them. वो कहीं अच्छी जगह उन्हें invest नहीं कर रही है, ना तो उस पैसे से कोई profit earn हो रहा है, ना ही interest earn हो रहा है, कुछ भी नहीं हो रहा है. They are just keeping their funds idle. So this will be the disadvantages of having excessive working capital. Next is leads to unnecessary purchases. Now, like company को एक्सपेंसेस करने के लिए सोचना नहीं पड़ रहा है, दे आर हैविंग सफिशियंट मनी और मोर देन सफिशियंट मनी, सो वो सोचेगी नहीं, दे विल बाय, दे विल परचेज वट एवर दे वॉन्ट टू. सो इट विल लीड मोर एक्सपेंसिव विच आर मीन्स जो जरूरत भी नहीं है, अननेसेसरी जो खर्चे हैं वो भी इंक्रीज हो जाएंगे कंपनी के. सो दिस विल ऑल्सो इफेक्ट देयर प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी, देयर गुडविल और देयर एसेट्स. देन नेक्स्ट इज implies excessive debtors and defective credit policy. यहाँ पे debtors बढ़ने शुरू हो जाएंगे, credit policy सही नहीं चलेगी. The next is leads to overall inefficiency of the firm. Now देखिए कि company के ना तो debtors सही से manage हो पा रहे हैं, company के पास जो funds हैं, funds sufficient हैं, more than sufficient है, but वो कहीं पे use नहीं करने, idle रखे हैं, unnecessary purchases करें, जितनी capacity नहीं है उससे ज्यादा मटेरियल परचेज किया जा रहा है, सो क्या होगा, इनएफिशिएंसी विल बी अराइज, सो इट विल इफेक्ट द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी ऑफ द फर्म. द नेक्स्ट इज बैड रिलेशनशिप विद बैंक एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन. क्योंकि जो कंपनी है वो एक नेगेटिव वे में चल रही है, दे आर नॉट इन्वेस्टिंग फंड्स, सो हाउ दे विल गेट लोन, दे आर नॉट इन द प्रॉफिटेबल सिचुएशन, दे आर कीपिंग देयर फंड्स आइडल. इफ दे वॉन्ट funds, so they can invest their reserves. So there will be bad relationship with banks and financial institutions. There are some determinants which tell us how much working capital is required by a business concern. So now let's see determinants of working capital requirement. They are nature or character of business, size of the business and scale of operation, production policy, seasonal variation, credit policy. Like, अगर कंपनी बड़े स्केल पे रन हो रही है, उनकी प्रोडक्शन या कैपेसिटी ज्यादा है, so they will require more working capital as compared to other. Production policy कैसी है, credit policy कैसी है, means क्रेडिट कितने टाइम के लिए क्रेडिट अपने सप्लायर से ले सकते हैं, कितने टाइम के लिए क्रेडिट अपने डेटर्स को प्रोवाइड करते हैं. लाइक अगर कोई कंपनी डेटर्स को कम टाइम पीरियड के लिए क्रेडिट देती है, वहीं एक कंपनी डेटर्स से ज्यादा टाइम पीरियड के लिए क्रेडिट दे देती है, सो किसकी वर्किंग कैपिटल रिक्वायरमेंट ज्यादा होगी? यस, उसी कंपनी की जो ज्यादा टाइम पीरियड के लिए देती है, बिकॉज they are not converting their sales into cash, so unki requirement zyada hogi. There is season variation also, like season on ho raha hai, so us time period pe company ki working capital requirement zyada hogi as compared to that season in which there is season off. Off season mein unhe kam zarurat hogi working capital ki as compared to the on season. So these are some determinants which can determine the requirement of working capital. It's enough for today's lecture. So in next lecture, we will talk about some numerical part of working capital management. Till then, keep revising and stay safe. Thank you all.